I met Sean when he was in the midst of his induction therapy, which was started by a colleague of mine from Las Vegas. So Sean consulted, several doctors before he came to us with his mutations, with his young age. He was certainly a patient with a high-risk myeloma than average, I would say. Usually the average age of when patients get diagnosed with myeloma is 69 years old.
I'm currently 41 years old. I was an airline pilot for multiple years. Also, my wife and I did a lot of business ventures throughout the years. I was running and started to feel as if I had a groin pull, and after 2 months, it actually started getting worse. To my surprise, I went after my MRI to visit the doctor, and he told me that I had multiple myeloma, which I had no idea what it was whatsoever.
It just felt like our world had just paused and that it wasn't gonna be the same.
And then we ended up finding out about CBCI, and thankfully we have family here, so it was nice that we had a good facility to work with and some family support to go through it, because it was a long, drawn-out process.
Overall, yeah, for sure. I mean, I'm way less fatigued, like I said. I'm not sleeping.
For me, it's a big deal to help Sean because, he's a very young patient that has a very bad disease in a very young age.
I think about 80% of my bone marrow was filled with the myeloma cells at that time. And from there, they said, well, I think we're gonna try to go ahead and get you in this CAR T-cell treatment. There was only a few slots in this area, and I was really, really thankful to receive one of those slots.
CAR T therapy is where you collect the patient's own T-cells in order to send them to a certain pharma company who engineers and changes the T-cell into an anti-tumor T-cell with an antibody on top of the surface that is able to attack the tumor cells.
Today I'm getting my cells removed for the re-engineering. We're going to send them off to Atlanta.
When we know that the CAR T-cells are delivered, we keep them cryopreserved in liquid nitrogen until we have the patient ready for the what we call lymphodepleting chemotherapy, so that the CAR T cells don't get rejected by Sean's body and that they are able to survive in his body and also expand in his body. And once that's completed, then we will take the CAR T cells out of the liquid nitrogen and bring it to the bedside. It will be thawed and then transfused into the patient. And from there on, this is kind of what we call day zero of the CAR T-cell treatment.
It's a little bit nerve-wracking and scary that you don't really know what to expect, even though they tell you. You don't really know how your body's gonna react to it.
When Sean was at home with me after the CAR T-cell treatment, I was always on high alert just in case, he had one of the adverse effects.
His response was excellent. I think there was barely any myeloma left 1 month post-treatment.
I think I'm 3 to 4 months out right now. I'm in remission. This is the first time I've ever gone this long since almost 5 years ago of getting diagnosed without having chemo. So it's amazing in a sense of quality of life is getting better every day.
This is really amazing. I mean, what we could do for him, 2 years ago, that was not really possible to offer him.
What I would say about CBCI is it's an amazing place. The staff is just unbelievable. It's a very welcoming, friendly environment in that people there really do care.
It's the perfect place for him, and I'm just so grateful that they were able to get him a spot for the CAR T-cell treatment.
They're very honest with you and straightforward and say, hey, this isn't looking good right now, but here's the plan to get through it. So I don't feel like I was ever really scared because I always felt like I had a good team in my corner.